The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling this very great, unique word of truth. Glory be to my Yahweh Sidkenu, to the highest, and peace be to the mankind on this earth, to those who believe in my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by faith alone, in Christ alone, in order to know what is the reality to be called in the Lord for His great service. So that anyone who serves our Lord, not only being the pastor teachers, but in fact even indeed every believer who walks according to the will of that great Lord God Almighty, that great Lord God Almighty certainly honors them. And peace be to be the mankind on this earth, to those who believe in my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by faith alone, in Christ alone, so that they could truly know the true calling in the Lord, wherewith they have been chosen in Christ. And double peace and double honor and double glory and double joy while they are still alive on this earth, those who walk after believing in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by not forsaking, neither relaxing in the things which they can think it could be relaxed, but they certainly preserve the word of the Lord because it is their life, and prove their righteousness in God. For them, the great account which could be added to their account, the great glory, will certainly reveal in the things to come in the future, when they are being judged at the judgment seat of Christ, the greatest glory of the Lord. So, dear brethren, in order to make things straight, so that the things that we learn in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, could be enlightened for us, because the natural man, or the things pertaining to the soulish man, they cannot understand the things of the word of the Lord. But we have been given to understand Bible doctrine in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, by faith alone, in order to know that after believing in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you have to be the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, reigning and ruling in you, in order to make sure that you have been controlled of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, in the privacy of your priesthood. We shall use the rebound technique, the confession of our sins, and get back and learn the word of the Lord. So we shall have a word of prayer and start today's word, which our Lord has prepared and kept for us, in order to know what it is to prove that is acceptable in the sight of God. Because when we, being humble ones and not poor, the translation between the humble ones and the poor ones has a lot of different meaning. Poor may be the people who are not enough rich in the word of the Lord, but humble ones are the people who really want to know and learn the word of the Lord, so that our Lord will arise and help and certainly give them that which is due unto them, the daily manna of spiritual food designed in eternity past, so that in this earth, while they are still alive, they could follow my Lord and could show forth what it is to rather reprove those things that are in dark, and not being joint partakers of them, but telling to the world that they are the techna children of God, because they are in light, walking in light, and yielding the fruit of the Spirit only in light. So we shall have a word of prayer with our head bowed down, and we shall learn the enlightenment spirit of the word of the Lord and understand His calling for us. So we shall have a word of prayer in the privacy of our priesthood.